bill with a single payer? Why not scrap our broken and Wall Street greedy health insurance system to the schools to not provide healthcare, cut the cord for employee benefit healthcare that makes U.S. businesses less competitive and that disappears when the job does, dispense with all the paperwork of multiple insurers that doctors take, and go for the fairness and streamlined simplicity of approved Medicare for all? Congressman Connors, Bill H.R. 676, which is a single-payer plan that actually saves money and does not require a death certificate to describe it.
How did I know that question? Two things. First of all, President Obama's comment. This bill that is on the House side, actually, according to the Congressional Budget Office, covers 97% of all Americans. The 3% it doesn't cover, according to the Congressional Budget Office, are those who choose not to be in it. And they're going to be fine a little bit, because we want them to be able to pay for it. So it's not, I appreciate what the president said, but he's looking at probably a bunch of bills, and on the Senate side, that's a horse of a different color. There's about five horses running that race over there. And I don't mean that in a bad way, it's just different. And so this really is about as universal, I don't mean universal single payer as you can get, because I'm sure this thing will happen on the other. Now, let's talk about universal healthcare, and I appreciate it on this. And I know I'm going to get feedback on this because I had more meetings with single payers. Lonnie Frank. Who else? So many people. How many people have had discussions with me on this? Many years. Jim? Here's what I said on this. And I can tell you it's on the table. I can tell you it's out there. I want you to know right up front how I feel, what I believe. Yeah. You need to know. I'm a representative. Because we're so far down the road, we know where we're headed in the general direction. And I agree with the way we're headed. There's three primary reasons as I work my way through why I believe that in the longer term, you will have a longer term, better quality, more affordable, if the plan that I talk about today works. The three are the following. First off, we tend to subsidize the single-payer systems in other countries like England or Canada. On average, for example, they pay from the same pharmaceutical industry about 33% for their drugs that we pay. If they had to pay the full-up cost that we do, it'd be a lot more burden, and you'd have to wonder, according to the budget, how long they could sustain it, is that example. So, to some degree, it's a little unfair playing here. Number two is, I come from the Navy, and I love it. And I kind of kick people. I love the Navy. I shouldn't say this, but I can't. This is the best job I can, if you can't be in the Navy. but we canceled a ship about 6 weeks ago in the House Armed Services Committee that I'm on. It was a destroyer. And for those Navy people here, you know how destroyers aren't that big. The cost of it 7 years ago was supposed to be $1.2 billion. When we canceled it, it was $5.5 billion a piece. Because there's no real competition. Only one shipyard, for example, builds an aircraft carrier. And so we kind of have to take what they give us. Now we can mandate that they only give us so much, and we say, well, I can't do it for that. To some degree, we're a single, not payer, we're a single buyer. And I have believed that ultimately competition, but transparency and fairness of that competition, like the public health commission doing that, with the minimum standards you have to do, best disciplines cost. The question is government accountable enough in setting up the right incentives? So I have found in the Navy and military, for example, we have $10 billion today in unused spare parts sitting on the shelf that will never be used, as the government accounting office says, we're just buying more. You tend to get into an almost automatic loop. Doesn't mean it can't be fixed, but the gentleman who passed the question about Medicare wasn't totally wrong. It goes bankrupt in 2017. It's not single payer, but it's close to it. And so my take on it is, government does do things well. In where people are, does things net in certain areas. It does have to be involved in certain necessary areas. For example, I think Uber Hungry had it right. The moral test of the government is how well it takes care of those in the dawn of life, the children, S-CHIP. He didn't say S-CHIP, honestly. Those in the twilight of life, the sick, disabled, the handicapped, the Medicaid. Those in the twilight of life, the seniors, Medicare. But on the whole, it's a transition in life, and people are having a tough time. I feel that in the longer term, competition will find a new innovative drug and induce people out of the selfish do so if it's managed in the right way to reduce students can best discipline cost and quality in the future. That's what I believe, and I'm happy to listen on that because I think we have at least two single payers here. I'm kidding. It's a joke, no one's late.